Hey YouTube, this is just your friendly neighborhood cripple, just out here making, with an important question, actually. Okay, all of you have heard of Simon and Garfunkel, right? So, I don't know really what other songs they wrote, but I think that they might have been prophets, when they wrote this song, The Sound of Silence. And I'm just wondering what you think. Like, do you think The Sound of Silence lyrics were actually written about cell phones? Were Simon and Garfunkel being prophetic when they wrote this song? Okay, here are the lyrics. Hello darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. Okay, so that whole verse sounds like a prophet to me. I mean, they had a vision, and while it was sleeping, left its seeds, it still remains. That sounds like prophet. Okay. In restless dreams, I walked alone, narrow streets of cobblestone. Neath the halo of a street lamp, I turned my collar to the cold and damp. When my eyes were stabbed by a flash of neon light. Okay, this is where I think it gets freaky. Okay, his eyes were stabbed by a flash of neon light. Hey, what do you think that is? It's a cell phone, I think. My eyes were stabbed by a flash of neon light that split the night and touched the sound of silence. I believe that. Okay, and in the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more, people talking without speaking. Hello, have you heard of text? People hearing without listening. Have you heard of text? People writing songs that voices never share. Exactly, because there's all these apps out there where you can write songs, but you never have to actually, like, do anything with them. There's all these, anyway, so people writing songs that voices never share. No one dare disturb the sound of silence, because have you noticed that nobody wants to interrupt people on their phone? Like, even me, when I'm rolling around in and I get close to a store or whatever and I notice there's people walking by with cell phones or whatever, then I turn my music down because I don't want to disturb the sound of silence. Fools, said I, you do not know. Silence like a cancer grows. Hear my words that I might teach you. Take my arms that I might reach you, but my words, like silent raindrops, fell and echoed in the wells of silence. Yeah, exactly, because no matter how many people tell you the sound of silence is actually about your cell phone, or how many people tell you silence like a cancer grows, I mean, who knows? Maybe all of, like, okay, so we have songwriters that are writing songs on their phones and nobody's ever sharing them. We have singers that are singing songs and nobody's, like, really, like, silence, like a cancer grows. I mean, what are we really doing with these cell phones? I mean, is it helpful? Like, I mean, I'm sure they're helpful in many ways. I love cell phones, but, like, maybe we are getting a little too carried away. Okay, anyway. And the people bowed and prayed. So what exactly does this look like? Bowing and praying. Like, can you get any more self-explanatory? Okay. Bowed and prayed to the neon gods they made. Hello, meet my neon god. And the sign flashed out its warning, and the words that it was forming, and the sign says, the words of the prophet are written on the subway walls. I'm sure on subway walls out there somewhere, somebody scrawled, cell phones are crazy. I don't know. And tenement halls, and whispered in the sound of silence. So if you agree with me, if you think that cell phones actually are the sound of silence in Simon and Garfunkel were actually being very prophetic when they wrote that song, then tell me in the comments below and be sure to like, comment, subscribe, all that crap. Thanks, bye. Wait, I have to get my mouse over there where it stops it. Okay, now, thanks. Bye.